This is a very interesting story of two obese kids born to non-obese parents. The second SIB came to me at the age of 3 months. The child had a weight of 7.2 and had excess weight all over the body. The child could not feed in normal position. The mother had to lie down supine. Then the child used to go prone on the mother, and then the breastfeeding procedure used to take place. There was nose block at night and recurrent vomitings. This story, friends, with this story I was okay. But when they narrated the story of first SIB, I was not okay. The first SIB, who was born 2 years before, was 2.5 kg at birth and 10 kg at 8 months, 11 kg at 1 year. Recurrent infections almost every month. The child had pneumonia almost 3 times, was admitted, got a blood transfusion, recurrent skin infections, and finally succumbed to death to these infections. The second SIB, who had come to me at 3 months, was 2.8 kg at birth and had umbilical hernia. Friends, what is hernia? It is weakness of muscles, and weakness of muscles is vitamin D deficiency, one of the causes. So this is also an indication during examination. And before he came to me, he was admitted once for respiratory tract infection and loose motions. The vitamin D tested was 11 nanograms. The child was put on 15,000 international units per day for 2 months. Obesity somehow requires a very large dose, because all vitamin D what you give is sequestered into the fat. After 20 days, and I was very happy to know that the child has had less of crying and the child could feed in normal position. Although he showed a 500 gram weight gain in 20 days, his urine output was increased. This is a typical finding I always find after vitamin D supplementation. The child was responding better to sounds. He was taking weight on limbs, sleep better, with less of night wakenings. The sucking power was better. What is sucking power? It is actually a muscle power and nervous system also, which improves, and the child is taking better milk. Third visit, that is 4.5 months. The mother said the child was passing black smelly stools almost 4 to 8 times, and the child was for 10 days. And at this juncture, I am very, very happy, because I call this as marathon bowel cleaning. All that food stuff which gets stuck inside the intestinal wall turns black. And I find this is one of the factors of many diseases. And when this step happens, I always expect better results in next visit. And that was true. At 5 months of age, the mother said the legs now look thinner, the abdomen distension is less, the development has picked up. The child can be from supine to prone, tries to sit. The cooing sounds are louder. It is all muscles. And the child can extend his neck and see upwards. And play and feedings are better. But the cuff appeared for 4 days, and this was an alarm to me that in spite of all my efforts, if infection has occurred, means this dose is also less. So I put the child on injectable vitamin D, 3 lakh units, 3 monthly, and always checked vitamin D levels, never allowed them to go beyond 150 nanograms per ml. The child had infections from 5 months to 14 months, but they were very mild and got over without antibiotics. we had to admit child only once at the age of 14 months. That was the same time the first sib had died, and I was very cautious about the child. Got admitted, received antibiotics, but the child got all right. A peculiar pattern of recovery I never came across before. The mother said the fat loss was first in legs, then in abdomen, then in chest, then neck, then the double chin went away, and then the face. And mother says, bas iske baad aur dubla mat karna. And this is about the child's graph. The weight has now come in the normal, and the height is touching the highest level. And this is the sweet child at 1 year, 5 months. And this is last I saw on 8th of this month, 1 year, 11 months. And if I happen to compare the two sips, first and second, the first had delayed motor development, second normal. First with delayed speech, second normal. First had very severe infections monthly. The second had infection but very mild and less frequent. And the parental fear for illness was more in first sip, less in second. And about the life, the first one succumbed to infection and the second one is enjoying his childhood. Friends, how did this happen? 1988, the years of my residency. From that time we know that in obesity vitamin D is low. And there are lots of studies which repeated the same thing that vitamin D is low in obesity. Yes, the same thing. African American children are at a very pitiable state because they have a skin of African that is thick, hyperpigmented, lots of melanin, and when they shift to America with less of sun, they do not get vitamin D at all, and therefore I hate migration. And this also says the same thing. Vitamin D is related to BMI, obesity, and type 1 diabetes, and large waist, and to multiple diseases including diabetes, many diseases. If you give vitamin D to a non-obese child and an obese child, the non-obese will show a greater rise in vitamin D levels as compared to obese. And friends, both pandemics, vitamin D deficiency pandemic and obesity pandemic, are gripping the whole world very rapidly. And there is a cause-effect relationship. People say that there is maldistribution. All the vitamin D you give goes into fat, and there is decreased bioavailability. Sequestration of vitamin D into fat. But how does vitamin D act? There are vitamin D receptors present in adipose tissue. Adipose tissue also can synthesize 125-OHD. It can regulate the adipose tissue mass, its differentiation and metabolism, and therefore it can contribute to controlling obesity. Vitamin D, obesity and asthma, one group. Vitamin D, obesity and cancer, another group. Vitamin D, diabetes and obesity, third group. And about the bariatric surgery, which I never like. The patients who go to bariatric surgery are vitamin D deficient before the surgery, and thereafter you cannot elevate their vitamin D levels if you give them oral because of the malabsorptive procedures. And finally, friends, in obesity management, vitamin D is a good addition. If you have any questions, you can give in writing.